Hi, I'm David from RACOM, and today I'd like to show you how to power up a RAID 3 microwave link, access its admin web interface, and change settings. What will you need? The link consists of two RAID units, two power supplies, mounting accessories, antennas, cables, and typically other equipment like grounding and surge protection, which depends on the installation site. For this tutorial done in lab, we will only need two units and two power supplies, and of course a computer to access the admin interface. We recommend performing power up in a lab, making sure everything is in order before venturing out in the field. Now, let's get started. First, let's open the box. Our standard shipping layout is such that units within a box are oriented towards each other. This allows doing the initial configuration without taking the units out of the box. If you were interested in other contents of the box, please have a look at our unboxing video here on YouTube. There are two power supply options, power over Ethernet or DC power. In this tutorial, I will be using both options for a DC power supply, an optional DC power adapter from RACOM must be used. This robust adapter has been made especially for RAID, and its long-term reliability has been proven in thousands of installations in all weather conditions. Now let's plug both power supply cables into connectors marked Ethernet 1 plus PoE, marked on the unit itself, as well as in the upper part of the cardboard packing insert within each box. You can immediately see that the units came alive by watching the Ethernet port LEDs and also the bright status LED of the RAID unit located under the protective cap on top side of the unit, which is at the very bottom if the units are still in the box. As soon as you see an interchanging green and orange light, you know the unit is booted up and ready to work. Now you have two options. You can either connect to the unit directly by an Ethernet cable or use Wi-Fi. Direct connection can be achieved by connecting your computer by a standard Ethernet cable to any Ethernet interface available on each RAID unit. When a PoE is used, plug your cable into PoE. In case of DC power use, Ethernet 2 with appropriate SFP module inserted. For a direct connection, your computer IP address should be 192.168.169.250/24, and the L unit is then available on its default IP 192.168.169.169, and the U unit is on the same address ending with 170. There is also a USB port under the protective cap. The units come with a USB to Wi-Fi adapter plugged into it. It is also possible to use a USB to Ethernet adapter instead. Be aware that only RACOM provided USB adapters are compatible with the unit due to the need for appropriate firmware drivers. With the USB adapter, your IP address is set automatically by DHCP and the unit address is 172, 17, 17 and 17. The simplest way to connect to the unit is to use the pre-installed Wi-Fi connection, which is what I will be using in this tutorial. A booted RAID unit in default configuration generates a new Wi-Fi network called RAID, order code, including L or U, plus its serial number. Wi-Fi does not require any password, but we strongly recommend configuring it during initial installation, since open Wi-Fi with service access is a huge security vulnerability. Your address will be assigned automatically via DHCP, so you don't have to do anything other than launching your favorite web browser and navigating to the unit's IP address. To log in to the unit management, simply type admin as both username and password and click the login button. Default settings of the units in the box automatically creates a radio link between them. RAID comes with a unique admin interface, allowing the user to manage both sides of the link at the same time. from a single screen. The top red bar contains link information, unit names and link status. The left sidebar features an expanded main menu with 5 top-level links: status, link settings, switch settings, tools and help. Now, let's try changing the station name as an example in this tutorial. Navigate to Link Settings and General. Change station name to something new, like Test Unit A and Test Unit B. Click Apply to save changes. All other parameters can be easily set the same way, as it is briefly described in our tutorial called Ray 3 Basic Setup. To learn more, please explore other Ray tutorials here on YouTube. All configurable parameters are displayed in great detail in the Ray 3 manual, available in the download section of the Ray part of RACOM website. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you have any questions, please reach out here in comments or via our website racom.eu. And as always, please like and subscribe to our channel. If you'd like to be notified about our new releases, also click the bell button. Thank you for watching and have a great day!